God did not make us robots
so that we would just concretely have to do his will. God did not program us like a computer, or he didn't just have a remote control to make us do everything to demonstrate his will. God gives us free choice. We must be cognizant there's a conflict which seeks to replace the will of God in our life. This is called the permissive will. Say permissive will.
Permissive will.
It's God allows us to do what we want to do.
Yeah.
Right.
I wish God could, would. He could if he wanted to. Just make everybody do what they're supposed to do.
All right.
But it doesn't work like that, right?
Yeah.
This means that he allows you to do what is contrary to his will. Everyone here has done something that's contrary to the will of God.
Yes, sir.
I don't care if you're a preacher, missionary. I don't care if you go to church every Sunday. Nobody here is perfect.
Amen.
This hindrance of doing the Lord's work in our life is when we do it our way rather than God's way. Let me put it like this. Let me say this. It's doing what you want to do and having it your own way will always hinder a person from doing Jehovah's will in their life. Amen. But that's not all that this lesson is saying. Not only does God have a will, and man also has a will, but we've also got to understand when I seek to demonstrate God's will, Satan also has a will. Y'all do believe in the devil in Florida, right? If you believe in the devil, just look at your neighbor. I believe in Satan. Some preachers say there ain't no devil, but I'm just checking. Satan seeks to hinder us from doing God's will. The will of God is in direct opposition to the will of Satan. The enemy of God wants to stop everyone from demonstrating and following the plans of the Father. Satan is against God. He's against God's kingdom. He's against God's people. And he will seek to hinder us, the people of God, from demonstrating a life that shows God in our life. The victory over the devil always is doing the will of God. And I do realize that in the end, there will be a final victory over the prince of this world. But Satan is busy seeking to stop you from demonstrating God's will. Am I right? Last of all, God's will and the Holy Spirit. If you're going to demonstrate God's will, it's the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God reveals God's will. God does not give us everything all at once, but to demonstrate God's will, we must yield to the Spirit. God wants us to live our lives in the Spirit and in his will, and walking in his way. One focus on the word Spirit, no doubt. The Apostle Paul speaks of this Spirit of God in the Old Testament. The Hebrew word is Raka. It's a word for the Spirit. It's a word for the wind. It carries the idea of power about it. And it should make your mind run in Acts to that mighty rushing wind. But the spirit is also more, it's more than what is human, it's divine. Therefore, I can say the spirit represents the power that is divine. In our church, we did a study on a book entitled The Forgotten God. And the whole thesis of the book is saying that we know God the Father, we talk about God the Son, but the third part of the Godhead is the Trinity. The Spirit is God. The Holy Spirit has the power to take control of your life so that you will be able to demonstrate the will of God in your life. Yeah. This is the power that sets the believer free. This new life of the Spirit is made possible through our faith in Jesus Christ,
yes,
when we accept him as our Lord and Savior.
Oh, yes.
And it brings about deliverance from the bondage of sin.
Yes, sir.
It allows us to demonstrate the will of God. This is the person who truly believes and wants to follow in the footsteps of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Most of us live beneath our privilege because we don't follow the way of God.
That's right.
We follow our own will. We follow Satan's will.
Right.
Do never live beneath your privilege.
Lord have mercy.
But the Spirit of God wants to control your life. Time is almost up, but it reminds me of a story of an infant named Cyrus.
Mm-hmm.
They wanted to put this infant to death. He was given to an officer of the court for destruction, for he was a royal baby. But instead of destroying the baby, they gave the child to a herdsman who adopted the baby rather than destroying him. The child grows up in a peasant hut. He lives believing that the herdsman and his wife are his parents. He was ignorant of his royal lineage, his rightful destiny of the royal palace and the kingly state. For in his mind, he was a peasant's child.
Mm-hmm.
But at last, the secret of Cyrus' birth and his rightful place gets known. And he goes on to be a man who stands out as a grand figure,
mm-hmm,
for he's royalty.
Yes, sir.
He's a child of the king.
Mm-hmm.
We are living beneath our privilege.
Yes, sir.
When we don't realize whose child we are,
yes,
whose our father really is.
Yes.
You cannot let the negative will, the devil, Satan, and your own will control you. You've got to demonstrate it in your life. Let me just throw these out and I'm in my seat. What I think we have is called, I want to label it the Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde syndrome. What do you mean, preacher? Well, whenever I desire to do good, evil
always
is always present.
Yeah.
And so here I am in my life. I'm seeking to live out my destiny.
Mm-hmm.
All of us have a destiny. I'm seeking to live a life that's pleasing to the Father. I'm seeking to demonstrate this every day of my life. We need to follow after the Spirit. Y'all have the rise and falls down here? Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Can you hear me now? The Spirit is always there.
Yes, yes, sir.
But we must yield our life to the Holy Spirit so that we can do the will of God in our life. God's will is demonstrated when it's effectively demonstrated because we're living in the Spirit also that leads to D. Are you with me? In other words, I've got the Spirit of God. I have the Word of God. And in order to let me live my life so I can demonstrate it each and every day. God chose Israel in the Old Testament to, as the apple of his eye. He chose them for a reason, so that they could be light to the world. He chose them so that they could show what it means to have God on our side.
Yeah.
Are y'all with me?
Yeah.
When you get to the New Testament, just this idea of light, Jesus said, let your light shine before men.
Yes,
so they'll do what? See your good works and glorify the Father which is in heaven.
Yes,
and so I'm demonstrating God's will by letting the light shine.
Right.
Me and my daughter, Jessica, now in medical school, but when she was a child, we were riding. We were riding in the car. And she said, Daddy, why did you go this way to the church? It's so nasty. It looks so dark. And I said to myself, that's a good thing to see. The world is dark.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
It needs some light.
Yes. Yes.
And we need to demonstrate God's will in our life. Time is up, but let me just share two things I'm sitting down. Abraham is a good example in your Bible of looking and demonstration of God's will.
All right.
Pack up.
Yes.
And I want you to leave.
Yes, sir.
Where you going? I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
That's how we have to live our lives.
Yeah.
Demonstrating God's will.
Yes, amen.
Joseph is another good example. What do you mean by Joseph? Well, God had destiny for him.
Yes, he did.
And his will was eventually shown in his life. But he had to stop by the pit and the prison before he made it
to the palace.
Yes, sir.
I pray this Bible lesson on demonstrating God's will has been a blessing in your life.
Yes, sir.